version 1.1 of the Do-more Designer is a major update, and at Automation Direct, there's no cost for Do-more Designer software updates, so be sure to download and install it. You'll be glad you did. If you right-click and copy a code block, and then right-click again and say paste code block, it now works exactly as you would expect. It takes the previous code block, makes an exact copy, changes the name by adding the word copy up front, and drops it right in place. You can change the name of that new code block by right-clicking and saying configure code block and change the name, or down in the output window, you can see a note here that we made a smart copy of a code block, and to rename that code block, just double-click on the message above, and you get the same dialog. Just change the name, and you're good to go. That's a quick and easy way to replicate tasks and programs, which is great if you have a machine with lots of similar functions. Of course, for that to work, you have to be in edit mode. Also, if you copy a section of code that contains local references, like this stage example right here, and then paste it in another routine, you get a dialog giving you some options on how you want things to be handled. You get to specify how the documentation should be handled, and you can specify if you want all of the references to change to the new code block. I do in this case, so I say paste it. And sure enough, I get my new stage program, and look, all the references refer to the new program, not the old one. Exactly what I wanted. Perfect. There's a new status bit called Ethernet Master Error that tells you when something's amiss in the new Ethernet I/O system. You just keep an eye on that, and when it lights up, you can then run a routine that will analyze the system and pinpoint the issue. You can do that by working your way down through this Ethernet I/O master structure. It has detailed status on every component in the entire Ethernet I/O system. Note that this new Ethernet master error flag also lights up that little yellow warning indicator you get down at the bottom of the screen sometimes. This new Ethernet missed frames gives you a count of the number of Ethernet frames that were ignored during a data storm due to limits on packet queue lengths. You'll want to keep an eye on that as a good indicator of Ethernet I/O system health. Stage programming now automatically increments the stage number. So if you have a stage here and another one here, and you add a stage, look, it automatically knows what the next stage is and populates that for you. I use a lot of stage, so I really like that one. Both the cross-reference and the documentation editor now allow you to pick a sort order. If you have a favorite sort order that you want them to default to, just go to View, Options, select the tab for the cross-reference or the documentation editor, and pick the default sort order right here. All of the items in all three panels of the Launchpad now have right-click context-sensitive menus, so you can right-click and you can see exactly what you can do with each element in any of these panes. Nice. The Do-more defaults to listening for other Do-mores on port 7070 hex. You can now configure a second port if you want to by going to Configure, CPU, and enable it right here, and put the port number right here. Note that this is decimal. You'll see the hexadecimal version right here. Once you have the CPU configured, don't forget that you also need to configure the link. So when you connect to a PLC, I'm going to edit this one since it's already existing. Under the Port tab, select Ethernet, UDP IP. You can enter your Ethernet address here, but under Advanced Settings is where you can configure that alternate port number. Again, this is a decimal number. When you bring up the Element Browser, you get a list of all the nicknames for all the elements in the entire system, which you could pare down by turning off the system nicknames if you want to, but in a large project, you're going to have a lot of nicknames here, so it still may not be enough. So if you want to pare that down more, there's a new filter right here that says Filter on Selected Range. What that does is now when you click on a range of elements, it only shows you the nicknames for that range. Here are all the output coils, for example, and here's some contacts. Very cool. Normally, when you bring up a cross-reference, it lists all the elements in your project with one exception, ranges of elements, like we have in this Reset Range of Elements dialog right here. It starts at C10, goes through C20. With version 1.1, though, you now see that range, and if you hit this Expand button, you see all of the elements in that range. That's really great because now you can't accidentally reuse an element just because it was hidden in a range. It used to be that you could right-click, and under this Debug Code Block menu, you could suspend or unsuspend a code block. With version 1.1, when you right-click and say Debug Code Block, you can actually run a program, trigger a task if that's what you right-clicked on, or halt a program or task. That makes it really quick and easy to control different programs and tasks that are buried someplace in your project. That's really handy. Now note, this only works if you're actually connected to a PLC. If I disconnect and try the same thing, that debug menu's gone, isn't it? You've always been able to zoom in or out on your ladder logic just by doing a Control-Shift-Num-Plus or Control-Shift-Num-Minus. Wouldn't it be great, though, if you could have all new views in a project start at the same zoom level? Well, now you can. If you go up to View, Options, and look under the Ladder tab, you can now set the default zoom level to anything you want. When you get a program that has lots of tasks and programs in it, it starts to get hard to figure out where each one is used and to find it when you need it. Well, look at this. Now if you right-click on a task or a program, there's this new cross-reference, and it lists every place that that task is used, and if you click on it, it takes you directly to the usage of that task or program. I use a lot of programs and tasks, so that makes my life a whole lot easier. Now keep in mind, that's only going to work the way you expect it to after you've accepted all your changes. When you get errors and warnings in the output window, what happens if you double-click on one of these items? Well, look at this. Now if you select any item, you get a little message right here that tells you exactly what will happen when you double-click. In this case, if you double-click, it'll go directly to the corresponding address in that code block. All of the enhancements covered in this video and the new features video are detailed in a PDF, which you can get to quickly by clicking this star right here. Be sure to check out that document for more details on what you've seen in this video. Many of the enhancements you've seen in this video came from users just like you. Automation Direct and Host Engineering take feedback seriously, so please keep those suggestions coming. How do you do that? Well, right here under Help, Support, look, it'll take you directly to Automation Direct Technical Support, Automation Direct Customer Forum, or the Host Engineering Forum. Drop them a note. They really appreciate the feedback, both the good and the bad. Check out the other DoMore videos in this series for more ways to get the most out of your DoMore system. And don't forget, Automation Direct's tech support is free, and you'll talk to a real, live person here in the U.S. within minutes. Got a question? You can call, email, or even do an online chat during regular business hours. Spend less, do more from Automation Direct.